FM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris Tim. The NACA East MP-elect Ronald Balimwezo has challenged the Supreme Court justices to professionally execute their duties. Balimwezo notes that the petition has put the justices on the litmus test, challenging them to be partial.
We opted to go to courts of law so that we can basically show people what our courts are about. So, courts of law are on a test. The people, the Ugandans, and the entire world want to see, with the kind of evidence that we have, what is going to be court's take on that. We are confident that our people are going to get information on as to whether our courts are really independent or not.
The Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, has directed members of the 10th Parliament that they should continue attending Parliament sessions as their term ends in May. This after the Kalungu West Member of Parliament, Joseph Sewungu, raised a matter of concern on the low turnup of MPs. Sewungu informed the Speaker that the MPs have been in their constituencies begging voters to renew their mandate, but now that Parliament is in session, they are nowhere to be seen.
Most of these members were in the village asking for votes, crying to come back here. Now the chairs are empty. They want some of them to find them along the road. We are handling crucial issues. When the parliament, and you are paying us, by the way, they are getting all the emoluments and everything. I don't know what method you're going to use to make these members know. They are supposed to be here. Whether they made it or not, they have to conclude their term.
So this prompted the Speaker, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, to remind members of Parliament that whether they won or lost in the just concluded general elections, they need to continue attending to Parliament work as their term expires in May.
The former losers can be future winners. Are you in order, Honourable Sewungu? Honour members, he's out of order, because in this house I can see members who did not make it rather diligently attend to their duties. But I just want to remind the members, the 10th Parliament expires in May. Therefore, you're required to be here to do the work.
The Ghana People's Congress wants teachers who had specialized in nursery teaching to upgrade to primary or secondary level, since they are not sure as to when the government will open up the pre-primary section. Last week, Education Minister Janet Museveni said pupils in the nursery section will remain at home for the meantime because it's difficult for them to observe the COVID-19 standard operating procedures preventing COVID-19. Party spokesperson Sharon Arach says teachers should consider upgrading the education level to be able to get placements in primary or secondary as they await government's final decision on the fate of pre-primary section.
She's coming here to redeploy, but she will not just redeploy someone who has been teaching nursery school into primary. So the government has to facilitate them to upgrade from the nursery level to the primary. For now, nursery is going to be phased out until COVID-19, which is very uncertain, we don't know when. So we ask them to let these teachers upgrade to a higher level, probably primary from P1 or even higher to secondary school, in order to be able to redeploy them in the different higher levels of education.
In world news, United Airlines plans to buy 200 flying electric taxis that it hopes will fly passengers to the airport within the next 5 years. The U.S. airline is one of the first major carriers to commit to the purchase of flying taxis. United Airlines will also invest in flying taxi firm Archer as part of a deal of $1.1 billion to develop the aircraft. The aircraft needs regulatory approval before the purchase can go ahead. In sports, Pep Guardiola hailed his special players as Manchester City rewrote English football's record books with a comfortable 3-1 victory at Swansea City that sent them into the FA Cup quarterfinals in a game played last night. Kyle Walker, Raheem Sterling and Gabriel Jesus were on target as Guardiola's team won a 15th game in a row in all competitions, with Swansea pulling one back late on through debutant Morgan Whittaker. The trap means Manchester City have set a new record for successive domestic wins by an English top-flight club, surpassing the previous best of 14 achieved by the Preston North End team of 1981 to 1982 and the 1987 to 1988 Arsenal side. And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News on point.